And I wouldn't trade any of it. I love my life. I do. I used to be single. Single life is just too hard, don't you think? Yeah, you're always broke when you're single. I mean, not plain broke. I mean, rolling pennies for gas broke. Macaroni and cheese broke. I was so broke at one point when I was single, the bank sent a guy to repossess my car because I didn't make a payment for a little over a year, all right? The guy shows up at my door, great big man. He said, "Mr. Foxworthy, I'm from the bank, and unless you have $500, I'm taking the Camaro with me." And I got mad. I said, $500? Who keeps that kind of cash on him? He said, "Well, you can't write me a check." I said, "No, I can't." A check? Hell yeah, I can write you a check. I thought you needed money. Tell you what, I'm going to go ahead and pay the whole thing off right now. I'm going to be a congressman when I grow up. Well, it's hard being single. I mean, you're starting out in your life. You don't have anything. You don't own anything. It's like the first singles apartment we all had. That's about as close as most of us ever come to being homeless as that first singles apartment. That was the apartment. You'd be driving somewhere, and you'd see where somebody had thrown an old sofa out on the curb, and you're like, "Hey, if that baby's there after dark, she'd be in my living room. Find me a board in a concrete block. We got an entertainment center happening here. I'll put them next to that orange road cone I found." Think back. Remember your very first apartment. They were all the same. They all had shag carpet. Beautiful green and gold mixed. Tramped down so bad in front of the door you couldn't even rake it back up. And our place was so nasty, every time we'd rake the carpet, we'd kick up a rabbit every time. They're all furnished pretty much the same way. In your bedroom, you had the mattress on the floor, protected by a mountain of dirty clothes, milk crates for nightstands, lava lamp with a permanent glob in the bottom, stolen road sign on the wall, a blanket for a curtain. Out in the hall, it was the mystery stain on the carpet, Budweiser mirror on the wall. Out on the balcony, it was the rusted out hibachi grill, plant with no leaves on it, bike with no chain on it. In the den, you had the spool. Remember this? You get one of those, like, it's coffee table time. Next to that, the $9,000 stereo. We're going hungry, but we've got tunes. That was a stereo. You could turn it on after midnight, make the people down the street wet the bed. Yeah. And the beanbag chair with duct tape on it to keep the shit from falling out of it. Which is why single people throw the best parties. They don't have to worry about their furniture getting messed up. Their friends can destroy everything they own. They're out $15. Single people do throw the best parties, too, don't you think? Single people throw parties where there's a good chance somebody's coming out of their clothes before the night's out. Most of the time, it's the woman that's dancing by herself way too early in the evening. It's only 7:15, Peggy's dancing by herself. That shirt's coming off tonight, I guarantee. And you know, some single people don't consider it to be a good party unless the cops have been there at least a dozen times. Same scenario every time. 400 drunks trying to act like they're not drunk. One guy is the spokesman for the group. "It's the cops. Turn the stereo down. Put your shirt on, Peggy. Hi, y'all be cool. Let me do the talking." "Welcome back, Officer Mitchell. Don't shoot." "I told him don't shoot. I told him don't shoot." "I'm glad you're back. I want to report a crime. Larry puked in the aquarium. Stinks very much bad in here." Hey, listen, if I lay down on the sidewalk, will you draw my picture with that little chalk y'all have? Shh. Shh. I'm talking to the cops. Shut up. Hey, Officer Mitchell, I thought you said you didn't want to come back out here again tonight. But those were the parties. Nobody went home. They just slept where they fell. Get up the next day, look like Jonestown the morning after. You're trying to wake up people you've never met before. Hey, man, with no pants and a fireman helmet on. Please get up. I got to go to work. All right, lock the door when you leave. Just found a new sofa. I don't want anything to happen to it. Only good thing about your first apartment, you never had to clean it up. Well, until the day you moved and tried to get the security deposit back. Arguing with the landlord. No, sir, the back door was missing when we moved in here. The pizzas were always on the ceiling. Because you find as you get older, you have to clean up. Or you have to at least try to make people think you do. We've all done that. Been home on a weekend, had the phone ring. Hey, we're in the neighborhood. Thought we'd stop by and see y'all. You always say, sure, come on. We'd love to have you. You hang up and do that flight of the bumblebee. 90 mile an hour, fluff and stuff. You're sweating when they get there, and the first thing you always say is, excuse the house, it's a mess. Y'all come on in, house is a mess. Why don't we ever just tell them the truth? Y'all, this is the cleanest our place has been in 6 years. Don't open the closet, you'll kill yourself. Don't open the closet. I'm convinced, too, whatever cleaning goes on the planet, women do 99% of it. But see, women are not as proud of their 99% as men are of our one. We clean something up, we're going to talk about it all year long. It might be on the news, you don't know. I guarantee you, a woman could be out repaving the driveway. Men have enough gall to run out on the porch and go, hey, baby, man, it's hot as hell out here, ain't it? Look, don't worry about emptying that ashtray in the den. I done got it, all right? Did it for you, sweet pea. I'm going to go take a nap now, all right? It's true. I was talking to a guy last night that thought loading the dishwasher meant getting his wife drunk. I did probably the hardest thing about being single has got to be the dating stuff. Like, yeah, any guys in the room ever go out with a girl that forgot to tell you she had a boyfriend? That is information you need. That happened to me. I went out with this girl one time, and we had a nice time. We went out to dinner, and after dinner, we came back to my apartment. Now, we've been at my place about half an hour when there's a knock on my front door. I walked out, opened the door. There's a 250-pound guy staring at me going, what in the hell you think you're doing with her? I looked him right in the eyes, and I said, I'm cutting her damn hair, and you're just going to have to wait, all right? Have you ever noticed this? Single people always have the best sex stories. See, and we know this because they share them with everybody. You know these people, you see them in the break room at work. They always have a crowd gathered around. So there I was, tied up to her bed. Had motor oil smeared all over my body. She came in the bedroom with a saddle and a set of jumper cables. See, married people just can't compete with this. Like, what are we going to come back with? Well, you know, last night, Marge was vacuuming in her good robe. She bent down to get underneath the sofa. I thought I can watch Bonanza anytime. Doesn't quite hold up. Talking about stuff like this, anybody see the sex expert on one of those talk shows the last week? This guy, he was trying to tell you how to spice up your sex life. If it had gotten boring, you know, boring, you know, like if you're doing it and the phone rings and you both try to answer it or something, you know, it's boring. So one of the things the guy said, he said, you should talk to your partner while you're making love. You know, which where I come from means ain't no cars coming, relax, right? But this guy said you should have dialogue while you're doing it, you know? And I thought, well, this might be good advice if you're talking about couples that have been together for a week or so. You know, because when they're talking, they're saying things like, I'm in the home stretch, go to the whip, baby, go to the whip. But y'all, let's be realistic. I mean, you've been married 25 years, you're going to be saying things like, lift your back, Betty, my arm's going to sleep. Did you pay the light bill? Move your head, I can't see the television. This guy said too, he said, in order to keep the spontaneity, you had to surprise your partner every once in a while. And I thought, well, he might be right. I thought, hell, I'll meet my wife at the front door in the nude. And I'm being sued by UPS, right? He said, too, he said, when you're in the video store, every once in a while, rent an X-rated video and watch that with your partner. Which, to be honest, I can't even look at the covers of those things without laughing. The women on the front of those, all of them supposed to be out of their mind with sexual desire, every one of them looked like this. I have never made a woman do that in my entire life. I hit a dog with a car one time, made him do it. Maybe it takes a Buick. I don't know what the...